Gilat and Borzat a little bit later on in the final group, and next taking to the ice, ninth after the short dance from Russia, Katerina Bobrova and Dmitry Soloviev.
And Katerina fell in the short dance, and the rest of the program from that point on just really deflated as they struggled to regain their speed and their composure. So they're certainly fighting for some redemption with this free dance today. Of course, with their Russian teammates of Ilinik and Katsalapov, whom we'll see later, they're certainly feeling the pressure that they're running the risk now of being overtaken by their younger teammates in Russian ice dance. That lift, let alone blind.
I guess it's good that it's a sheer skirt.
Yes, you know? That's happened at every event. I have to wonder if that was intentional to make it a little transparent. Finally getting through a clean twizzle sequence, something they struggle to do all season long. Katerina really has a beautiful arch in her back, the ability to move her torso in a wide range of motion. It's one of the elements that really highlights all of the features of this program. Despite that beautiful arch, when they do get into their step sequences, like this, you can see how broken forward she is at the waist. Both of them really in a hunched position. It allows you never to really get close enough to have clean turns, and it just looks so forced and struggled. They really have to work on getting their hips forward to get a little bit of flow through those step sequences and far closer together. Mistakes, but I have to say, after having just watched the Italians of Capellini and Linote absolutely captivate with their performance, this one left me feeling quite flat in comparison.
Tough to follow what the Italians had just done, but a big disappointment for the Russians, the Winter Olympics less than 2 years away, and they will be far from the podium.
Are you trying to sleep with someone who sounds like a chainsaw? Now there's a brand new solution that thousands will use tonight to stop snoring instantly, and you should too. Introducing Z-Quiet. It's comfortable and easy. Just place it in your mouth for instant results. Z-Quiet is cleared by the FDA and designed by dentists, so it's safe and effective. Snoring can be unhealthy and is caused by a narrow airway. This produces noise and prevents deep, restful sleep. Z-Quiet gently positions the jaw slightly forward to widen the airway. Not only will you stop snoring instantly, but you'll wake up feeling rested and refreshed. Z-Quiet will put you in each other's arms again.
Z-Quiet's like magic. Literally, as soon as he puts it in, the snoring's gone.
Now you can try Z-Quiet for 30 days for only $9.95, and that includes the shipping. We promise that if Z-Quiet doesn't completely solve your snoring problem the very first night, send it back and never pay a penny more. Call this number or visit ZQuiet.com and reserve your ZQuiet right now.
It really works.
Bounce any checks lately? These days, banks can charge up to $30 a pop. But what about those checks you have to write? Call or go to MoneyMutual.com. We have the largest network of short-term lenders who could get you up to $1,000 in your checking account by tomorrow. No more bounced checks. No collection calls. No shut-off of services. Just be 18 or older with a minimum income of $800 a month. For short-term cash when you need it fast, go to MoneyMutual.com or call 1-800-585-CASH now.
To be in Nice, something you'll know about very, very soon. The 2012 Figure Skating World Championships and Ekaterina Bobrova and Dmitry Soloveyev coming to a close. A very, I think for them, obvious to say, disappointing world championships. That.
Yes, and you know, I think they skated that free dance probably as best as they could at this point in the season. I just feel like this wasn't the right direction for them to take this season. I looked back at their free dance from last season just recently and thought they looked so much more composed and graceful and elegant. Something about the direction that they took in their programs and their training this season just left them looking sloppier and not really showing off their best qualities. Hopefully next year they can get that sorted out with the feedback they'll receive.
Well, with ice dancing, to the untrained eye, speaking of myself, when it's good, you know it.
Yep.
When it's not, it's equally obvious, and
there
the marks speak for themselves. The free dance, 5 points, almost 5.5 points below their season's best, and that will rank them currently second overall, well behind Cappellini and Lenotte from Italy. And next up, the final couple of this next-to-last group. And taking to the ice now, Maya Shibutani and her brother Alex Shibutani, and her older brother. They were seventh after the short dance and seemed to be very disappointed by that result.
Yes, and it was very much the technical element score which hit them the hardest. They've improved their performance quality quite a bit this season, and that's something that they need to do regardless, so hopefully they can just nail those elements in the free dance. Out on that twizzle. Oh my goodness.
Wow.
This is just so uncharacteristic. The twizzle sequence is, in fact, what they've become most known for in the ice dance event, of having the fastest, cleanest twizzles. Really getting ahead of himself on that one.
A big disappointment early in this free dance program for the reigning bronze medalists. They were a big surprise in Moscow just a little over a year ago.
That mistake costly point-wise, but Maya and Alex, as individuals, are such perfectionists. They're very, very hard on themselves in training. They work incredibly hard, and you have to know that when they make a mistake like that, when you are such a perfectionist, it takes a toll on you emotionally as well. So it's left to them now to mask that disappointment until at least the end of the program.
Seems that no matter how high quality the rest of the program is, the audience can sense that there was such a big mistake earlier on. One of their favorite portions of the program, the audience just not involved at all.
I agree with you completely, and I was going to say, you know, one of the skills that you learn as you gain experience, which Maya and Alex are still doing, is how to make the audience and the judges forget about a mistake by the end of the performance. At least get your points in terms of the performance. I really felt like this was just disengaged from that point forward.
Well, if you looked at it on replay and took out the section where Alex fell, you'd think that was a pretty entertaining, solid program, but that was just a death knell early on.
It was indeed, and it's too bad, again, because the Shibutanis do have such wonderful elements. They have incredible lifts, which they execute to normally very high grades of execution. It was just the performance element this time around that fell flat, and I have to wonder if it had something to do with perhaps a knock to their confidence or security after the short dance. It seemed like they felt like they had skated so well and performed it so well, and then to have the scores not match that sentiment.
And just to remind, that was seventh place for the Shibutanis after the short dance.
And taking this free dance from the beginning of the season, they were looking for something that showed that they could skate with more freedom, with more abandon, not so precise all the time. And yet, that imprecision really went wrong here. It actually looked like he was trying to spin with too much aggression, too fast. But here we take a look at one of the highlights, these lifts. That's a straight line lift with a change of position, right into a six revolution rotational lift, also with a change of position, all under 12 seconds. It's pretty impressive, really. And again, the rest of the elements of this program were very well executed. They'll still have, hopefully, enough points based on these lifts and elements and footwork sequences to help them stay in the top 10, but certainly a disappointment, no matter which way you cut it. You have to wonder, after placing third in your very first World Championships, how hard it must be to wonder where to go from there.
Well, yesterday in the short dance, they thought they skated particularly well, but the judges only decided that was seventh. but today they have